Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and in the last week I've had a numerous number of people ask me if I would talk about this certain individual. As you guys can see from a couple of the screenshots I've had just in the last day, people are asking me about Dr. Noon Amin-Ra. I had to do a little bit of research and look at the guy and look at his social media, his web pages, and an interview done with him before I commented because I wasn't familiar with him. Now, before I jump into the unusualness here, let me just state up front, we can prove scientifically the guy's a liar. There's no need to look further than this if you want to know if the guy is telling the truth with his methods or not, or he's being honest, because he's claiming to violate the laws of physics and the laws of biology. He's claiming to be, while physically active, that's the key, physically active, to maintain a body weight of around 170 pounds, or he's 160-something, as an active male who lifts weights and works out on a 1,200 calorie vegan diet. All right, there's your problem right there. And the guy is claiming that he eats a single meal of 1,200 calories a day and vegan. The fact that it's vegan is irrelevant. That's not a problem. I have no issue with that. I have no issue with a guy being strong and muscular on a vegan diet. I have a problem with someone claiming that it is biologically possible to maintain body weight and muscle mass on 1,200 calories. All right, the laws of biology and the laws of physics say that this is impossible. And he's basically saying, well, if you just lower calories slow enough that your body will adjust. And he uses a lot of really, really weird and unusual words. But the gist of it, he is essentially telling people that they will only lose fat and keep their muscle as long as they bring the calories down low enough, or if they do it slowly enough. But yeah, 1,200 calories for a physically active male, there's no way he could maintain that body weight. He would eventually drop down to 110 or 120 pounds. Biologically impossible. And again, all the studies that we have say that he's full of shit. And basically, essentially, the guy is going to claim some metaphysical or spiritual or religious reason why he's able to do this invariably. And that's the problem you run into with these weird sorts of individuals. Just like we have the bro science end in the fitness world that we need to be aware of, we have all this kooky new age and spiritual shit that has worked its way into the fitness world that is fake. There's no such thing as a chakra, for example, yet you see all these yoga people talk about these different things and chakras. They're not real. That's just something they made up. It's made up by certain spiritual beliefs, and that doesn't make it real. It's not something that we can find in the body and study and measure. If it produced energy, we could measure it with instruments. So you get all this new agey silly shit, and this guy basically has a very, very unusual manner of typing. And then when I saw him speak, he's almost like he is in a heavily drug-induced haze while he talks. He's very monotone, and I must talk like this, and you can extend the augmentation of your autophagy by only eating 1,200 calories a day. He's got this very weird monotone way of speaking, and it's not normal. His way of typing isn't normal. And he's got some weird pseudo-Egyptian type cult that he's a part of that he seems to be promoting. And again, that's why he's got the Amin-Ra thing in his name. Just weird stuff. And stuff like this really has no place in fitness. This is not scientific. This is just another one of these trendy little silly cults that, like a lot of the yoga stuff, has spawned out of and everything else. There could be fitness elements to it. Again, weightlifting and eating a healthy, balanced diet of whole foods, yeah, fantastic. But when people start doing silly things like, oh, saying that you can maintain your muscle mass on 1,200 calories a day, eating one meal a day because your body isn't focusing on digesting food, it's now focusing on recovery and building muscle, not wasting energy digesting food by only eating this one small meal a day. This sort of drivel and nonsense isn't actually true. It's not backed by the research. Again, just crazy cultish nonsense. And so I would be very leery of this individual unless you want to go join a cult and drink the Kool-Aid one day. And that's your business. I'm not going to tell grown people how to live their lives. But this sort of stuff is just ridiculous, and it's probably worse for the fitness world than the whole bro culture is. This whole new agey cultish spirituality that gets thrown into fitness, it's something I've never understood why people buy into this stuff. But you know, to each their own. If that's what makes you happy, if that's what blows your skirt up, more power to you. But I am letting people know up front, this guy is kooky as fuck. And what he is actually publicly stating is verifiably untrue. Like, we can prove this with plenty of data. The human body doesn't work that way. Guy is full of complete shit. And I think he's just on a lot of drugs. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.